What's up, y'all? This is the day 317. Make a song, Bringer. What's up, Hard-Boiled Egg? Hey, dude. How's it going, man? How's school and everything? So today I'm going to draw a whole bunch of new enemies. I'm doing good, man. Doing good. I definitely need a break, man. I'm kind of been working on marketing like the last 3 days and kind of, man, I need to just take a day off. That's what I need to do. You dropped out? Why is that? What's up, Pedro? I dropped out of college too. I'll have you know. And I'm still an upstanding individual. Constructive part of society. That's right. I said it. I have value in stuff. Foes. Okay, so today I'm going to work on new enemies. Not the right time or subject. All right, cool, man. I support you in this decision. What's up, Big Mac Dev? Yeah. Hard-boiled. Yeah, that's right. Kids, stay in school or else you turn into a crazy freak like me. There's a weird text overlay above the chat overlay now. Is that because Twitch just added the chat replay thing? They did. Look at that. Good Lord, how do I deal with this? What do I do? Okay, give me a sec. I'll look at this for a second, see what I can do to try and get rid of this extra thing that Twitch just added. Wait a minute. Maybe this is them forcing their overlay. This is what chat. What's up, PMC? Dude, I don't know. I don't even know where the URL is for this. See, there's that one's got an address. This one doesn't have an address at all. It just says chat. What if I clear the history? I don't know, guys. Looks like Twitch broke the chat for us. Hold on, wait. What if I go to the dashboard? You're gonna get I get rid of that. Maybe that will help. No love? See, I know this thing is probably using some kind of like HTML to load the whole chat window, and there's no way for me to go and just click like the X box or whatever on top of this. Looks like Twitch forced this whole whatever. I don't know how to deal with that, so I'm just not going to deal with it. I'm going to get back to drawing some stuff. Hard boiled. What do you think? I can't get the hair right? Nice. Yeah, dude, the hair is just right, man. He's got a cool beard. I love it. I love this egg guy. What's up, KX? Oh, all right, PMC, I'm glad you got it fixed. Salad Dogs, what's up? Does it disappear after a while? Oh, that'd be great. That would be awesome. Twitch is having problems. Wow. Oh, long hair, right? How would you do that with a hard-boiled egg? That's I don't know. That's a creative question right there. Okay, so first thing I'm going to do today is warm up my pixel art by drawing a remix version of the Drobth. This is going to be a female Drobth. So I'll start with the idol. Actually, I'll rename all these. So I've got all these female PSDs all set up. And then I don't think I'm even using that first attack image. Jeez, this is a lot of art. Forgot how much there is here. Just can't make any kind of hair because I guess not awful for the first Pixar thing. Oh yeah, don't worry. Yeah, you know what I mean. Yeah, the first time you do pixel art, actually the first time you do anything, it can be really difficult. Just the little things are difficult. You know, you're like, gosh, how do I do hair? But it'll come to you, man. It'll come to you. And it may be that drawing, that particular piece of art, just doesn't really work with, you know, it's not meant to have hair. Might be that. Okay, the female's not gonna have a throw. Well, whatever. We'll start with the idol. Okay, so the female is gonna be a little shorter. She's gonna have some curly. Curly horns. Ah. Oh, I actually was drawing with a brush recently. What? The Elder Scrolls 3 Morrowind soundtrack. Oh, wait. I would listen to this right now, PMC, but I swear to God, this is probably going to flag my video as copyright infringement or whatever. But I'm glad you like it. Oh my God. Oh, it's because the brush is in eraser mode, or in brush. The eraser is in. There we go. All right. Come on. There. Oh, the troubles. The trouble I have sometimes. Trying to make art. Okay, here we go. Okay, so she's going to have like a curly horn. I'm thinking her head's going to be smaller. Her belly won't quite look so much like this. Smaller shoulders and all that. Maybe she'll have like two. Ooh, that looks scary. So I'm drawing a new enemy here. This is a female version of the Drobth. My goal today is to draw like three or four different new enemies, not necessarily do all their behavior and mechanics and programming and stuff like that, but just to draw them, to get the ideas out before too long. You know, I want to get, basically what I want to do with the game right now that the beta version's out, is I want to create as many enemies as I can, as fast as I can. It's same with the bosses too. I want to have lots of bosses and enemies in the game, so the game just feels more complete. Okay, Okay, that's just too much titty right there. Try and add a lot of titty and you just get too much. Oh, there, then that's a nice little titty right there. Right about that much titty. It's so funny seeing drawing this. I don't know why. All right, yeah. I don't know why this looks so funny to me. Yeah, you prefer a great deal of titty on your horn skull setters, right? This is what this is, right? Like maybe she has a little belt or something too. Hey, what's up, Emma? Welcome, welcome. Still thinking the arms are a bit too big. It's getting better. Too much, not enough. Too much, not enough. If you stop, I see what it is, Hardboiled. All right, so maybe she has a different eye configuration too. Is the right arm's a little big? Yeah, probably, huh? Make her twerk. Twerking, twerking foe, huh? You want your foes to twerk, huh? Maybe she just has one eye. Or one big eye. That's kind of interesting. I like that. His big eye. You want all the characters to twerk. Don't stop here, man. Keep going. Make them all twerk. I won't be happy until they're all twerking. Standing up, Cody guy. What's up, Blackbird? Sexist. I'm just trying to put multiple sexes in the game. Isn't that not sexist? I thought this would be a nice thing for both sexes to be in the game, huh? Both are represented. I think she's looking pretty good. I like this. I like this. This is a good start. I'm gonna go ahead and now animate the rest of her. That's because they're superior and that they can do just as much as the any man with only a quarter of the vision. Right? There is no such thing as sexism against men, is there? Has there been any recorded case in history ever? All right, so what? Okay, wait, hold on. Before, I think what was going on is that he was shrugging his shoulders. So I'll just make her shrug her shoulders as well. So we delete that. Let's duplicate this frame. Crack out the timeline. Oh yeah, we had these three. Okay. So that's a half a second. These are all gonna need to be 0.1 seconds. This is gonna be this frame. This frame again. Okay, now this frame, we just make her shrug her shoulders. Shrug it out. Shrug it, lady. Shrug. Twerk it. Why did you make the male version come up first? But does she has a giant eye lasers? Well, now there's an idea. Giant eye lasers. Yeah, all right, okay, so let's get this exported. This is the female idol, Drobth female. Oh, right, I forgot her name. Yeah, I don't know. You might end up summoning her. If you define sexism as unfair, unjustified bias against someone on the basis of their sex, I see no reason why it wouldn't occur against men. That's right. We get the brunt of it sometimes too. The shrugging animation. Yeah, it's true, right, Curdy? Yeah. I don't know. I don't know. I don't know. I don't know. Oh, wait, wait. Oh. I think I named all these wrong. Wait, no. No. I got it. Okay, oh, I got this. I got this. Okay, so some of these, let me start getting this the Drobth is hooked up to the in the game a little bit. So she can have a skin. Where do I get skins from? Blob. Blob has skins. Okay, yeah. So all the Drobth are always have this. They always have this female. No matter the difficulty, you can have a female Drobth. This will be random. All I gotta do is copy all these animations. Okay, great. And we only need those four animation, five animations. Okay, so now that we got that, we can do this and go dash female. That'll be an extra skin. And this is gonna be drop female idle. Female walk, hurt, attack, two, and die. Okay, so there's only five animations to do here. Hello, Phantozer. Okay, so I can copy this frame, use this as a basis for these next drawings. The next thing would be run hurt. Hurt's gonna be hella easy. Let's see the hurt really quick. This is a single frame animation. Just bends over. She bends over. Did I just say that out loud? No, really, she bends over like she's hurt. So I'm guessing, yeah. Right? Pema, yes. Songbringer will be moddable. Yep. If you look at the files for, if you have the game right now, you can look at the files for it, and it's very, very moddable type stuff. For example, like all these text files, these things, all there's so much loaded from data, so you can literally tweak any part of the game even right now. What's up, Zynger? Welcome, man. I'm working on drawing a female Drobth. This is like an alternate skin for the Drobth enemy, and yeah, hopefully I have enough time to get a bunch. Like, I'd like to get two or three enemies drawn today. I've got my sketchbook out here. And I got a lot of ideas for enemies, so I want to get a few of them out. So I'm just kind of getting warmed up with pixel art here by doing the female drop because I thought this would be easier than just easy to get warmed up, you know? Sometimes you need to get warmed up. Now you're not gonna be able to see her hand really as it goes behind. Let's clean up these horns a bit. Funny, our neighborhood has this rooster. You'll add a mod for twerking enemies? Yes! Make every single texture puppies. This is already possible. You want the puppy version? Go ahead. Okay, so her arm is into a little bit too much of a, like a powerful state. That's better. This arm too needs. Whoa, it comes back in this way. Whoa. Whoa. Reminds me of Toe Jam and Earl. Whoa. Twerking puppies, yes! You're gonna be rich! Why has no one else thought of this before? She looks like she's about to puke. Okay, good. Female hurt done. Bam. Bang, done. Wait, the question is she in the same place? Yeah, she is. All right, cool. All right, this frame done. This is the drop female hurt. This goes in sheets, foes. This female hurt, zero. Awesome. And that will be idle walk. Wait, wait. There's female hurt. Yeah. Okay, next up. Next up. What's next? We got the idle. We got the hurt done. We don't need attack. We don't need throw. In fact, I'm going to go ahead and delete attack and throw. Those were for some other guys. Walk would be best to do next. Walk, die, attack two. Attack two is really fast too, actually. This is a pretty quick frame. Boom, boom, boom. Okay. So starting again with idle. Starts here. Next frame, she's all the way horizontal like that. Kind of like punching with her arm there. Giant high laser's bright. Is Bob Fu still on vacation? I think he is. I think he is. I don't know. I haven't seen him today. Oh man, Boogie told me to do something too. He said if Bob Fu is not working, email me. I forget what he said to do. But yeah, Boogie can some can like start Bob Fu remotely somehow. Okay, so duplicate that once, twice, three times, made it. This is gonna be frame zero. It's gonna be frame one. This one's gonna be frame two. She's standing normal. This one, she's attacking. She's on vacation with Boogie. That's right. That's right. He's Bafu's sitting in the sunshine drinking a Corona right now. Bafu deserves it. That's right. This is always fun, just like randomly mashing pixels together. Pixel art's just real, it's nice. Boogie's putting suntan lotion on him. You're lagging, try refresh maybe. I wonder if this is fixed yet. No, the chat replay thing is still there. God damn you, Twitch. Your new feature has broken my old feature. Yeah, that's better. Gosh, this is where she just like rams. She headbutts you really quick. Bam! Headbutt. Didn't even see it coming. All right, so last frame, she's kind of in between this frame and that frame. Yeah, I know. I noticed there's an X under there, but there's nothing I can do to actually click that. So what's going on is this chat window thing that you guys see in the upper right corner is like a plug-in inside Game Show. And from what I understand, I think it works by loading an HTML page. Somehow it's loading an HTML page. But in the background, I can't change it. There's nothing I can do to change the chat's properties. It's bullshit. I don't have any control over this. I can't change it. I can't click that X. I would love to click that X. That'd be so cool. But no. It's just this wonderfully beautiful text you guys get to see, confusing your other text. All this stream, at least this stream, maybe for weeks to come, Twitch will force this on us, huh? This little notification in the chat window. It cannot be gotten rid of. They really want us to know. Can't you try to restart that chat? I don't know how I would do that. There was a clear button. I tried clicking it and it didn't do anything. All right. You can't deal with it. You can't make me. What if you pulled up a web page of the Twitch chat and then did a window capture of that? You could chroma key it. Oh, that might work. That might work. I'm not sure how game dev does its internals. Like, I'm pretty sure this, or a game show. I'm pretty sure this game show chat widget thing is actually built into game show somehow, but there's probably some kind of like source. I could probably do a web display. And then, yeah. So annoying, right? Yeah, I already did that, Hardboiled. I did the X in the chat dashboard. That did not help our stream on the other. And it's not actually connected to that. It's not actually. Yeah, it's its own HTML page from what I can gather. All right, let's clean up this frame and we almost done. There's only the walk animation left to do, I think. Oh, there's the die as well. There's the dying animation and the walk. All right. So this one needs a little bit of love. This frame is a bit, I think it just needs to shift one to the right. So it's a little more natural. If anything, her body should shift a little at this in this frame. Especially right there. Okay, a little better. All right, that's okay because it doesn't really matter how good this one is because it's such a fast animation that you won't really see it. Headbanging enemies mod. Yes. It's a headbanging show. Actually open a Safari window with the chat in it and do a window capture of that. Yeah. Okay, I'll play around with those kind of settings and stuff and see what I can find before tomorrow's stream. Okay, let's render this one. Female attack 2. Right. And that should be melee. See the die and the run. Okay, I'm just going to export this one. And then the female walk, this one does need to be done right now. So we've got a 4-frame animation going on with 6 of them. Do, 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 do. Okay. You want to make her a cute skipping animation? All right, so this first one, I think is like I'm. Yeah, that's his front leg. His right leg is in front. His left arm is forward a little bit. Right leg forward, left arm forward. Oh, I should make copies of this. Oops. Yips. Just gonna make them both visible so I can make this an easier process. And her like belt area is going to move a little bit. Man, I'm just starting to remember how busy of a week it was last week. There was a whole event last week, and then there was the beta release. Man, I'm still recovering. I need time off. I need to be on vacation with Bafu, sipping a Corona right now. Maybe I'll take some time off tonight or something. Maybe tomorrow. Yeah, but man, I gotta say, the beta release went really well. Really, really excited how awesome everything turned out with the marketing and just the response from everybody. So many great positive comments. And man, just like it's good stuff all around. Can't wait to be done with this homework. Ah, yay, you got the beta suite. Nice. Yep. I'm most excited to make more enemies right now. What's up, Arcane? What's up? What's up? Okay, I think this is pretty good for frame one, except for that. Her belly was a little bit. Okay, there. Frame one, done. Frame 2 is almost the same. Except he kind of like bounces upward a pixel. Arms go out even more. Okay, so there's frame one, and let's duplicate this and make frame two. Not needed there. Use it there. She bounces up in the air a pixel. Oh. And arms swing out a bit more. Chat replays are on Twitch now. Yeah, they got some kind of like new thing. It's kind of messing with the chat window up there and on the video, but I think it's gonna be a cool thing. From what I understand, they're just like integrating chat now into the actual VODs or whatever. So, you know, it'll probably be a bit of, you know, growing pains, I'm sure. Like, for example, today's stream, you can't really read the chat there in the top right, but hopefully this turns into something cool. Don't know how I feel about the chat replays. Something shouldn't be saved for posterity. There you go. There you go. We got pros and cons. Mm-hmm. What did I do? Mess this one up somehow. Oh, what happened? Damn it. Oh, still messed up. There. Okay, that's how it used to be. Let's go. No, don't tell. Redo. Step forward. Oh. Ah. Oh, Photoshop. Damn it. All right. Let's redo this. This was this frame. I don't know if I think I might need to move her up one. We're selling them. Why they don't allow more people to have subscribe buttons? I know, right? Why they don't? It's because it costs them money to have a subscribe button, because they have to like give. I don't know. What the hell do I know? You can actually apply though. Do you guys think I should apply? Should I apply for that? So there's a subscribe button. I don't know. They might. Do they play more ads and stuff? Like, do they make it all your stream all crappy? If you have a subscribe button. Okay, let's hope it doesn't break this time. They don't play more ads. Okay. The partners control when to play ads. Yeah, Arcane, I'm not sure. I'm not so sure about that, actually. I know this stream does not have that many viewers, and there's not that many people's, you know, following it or whatever, compared to, like, you know, the huge Twitch streams out there. But I've seen some other game development people in the same league. You know, they're not, they only have like 50 or so people watching it at a time, and they only have the same kind of, you know, same range of followers and all that, and they have a subscribe button. So I don't think it's necessarily, I think Twitch actually chooses that, you know, and they can realize, okay, this particular streamer here is a game development streamer, which means they're not going to have huge views or whatever. But, you know, so I think they're smart enough about it where they would allow it for some people's streams. But I could just be talking out my ass. I don't know. I think you get some control over when you play ads. Yeah. Right, yeah, it might be. But what's more important to me is what you guys, how it would be for you guys, because I don't really care. This game is going to, you know, all I care about is making this game. So, you know, if that's something that would be better for you guys, then I would do it. But if it would be worse for you guys, then I definitely wouldn't do it. So I don't know how would it be from your perspective if this stream was an actual Twitch partner with a subscribe button. Yeah, see, you know some game devs who have only 50 to 100 viewers with sub button. Yeah. It would potentially make it better for you. Okay. All right, well, maybe I will try that. Okay, we got two frames done. This next frame. Oh, this is the zero frame. Let's call this one 00. This one's 11. You don't think anything would change for you. Okay, so good. We got two votes for basically it wouldn't change much for you guys. None of them are your mother. Nice. Yeah, I mean, heck yeah. I probably should have done a Patreon a long time ago as well. But the game's actually getting enough alpha funding right now. People are really pre-ordering it a lot. And it's able to, you know, I'm able to continue developing past the point where my Kickstarter funds ran out. So, you know, I'm okay right now. But, like, it would, you know, yeah, of course. The more funds, the better. Because that means just there's more time than I can put into this game. Time and love and energy and all the other stuff that goes into making games. Okay, this frame. Things are a little different because, okay, his right arm is coming more in front. His legs are centered. His left arm is coming back. Okay, so I need to grab the original frame. It's tricky stuff. It's tricky making characters walk. It's probably one of the more tricky things to do in pixel art. How were your experiences in getting to market? Are you running a Kickstarter campaign, getting funds after that? Man, Lakebird, I'll tell you, like, running the Kickstarter was a lot of work. It was especially a lot of preparatory work, you know, just like months of preparing before the Kickstarter to launch it. But That said, I had no idea what would happen. I had no expectations. I didn't know if this Kickstarter would succeed or the Kickstarter would flop hard and I'd be sad or whatever. So when it finally actually succeeded and made more than I even asked for, I was stoked. It was incredible. It's probably one of the most positive experiences I've ever had in making games or creating things in general. You know, it was like really one of the most positive experiences I could ever imagine. Tons of positive energy from people, lots, you know, the funds to be able to make my game. Basically, I was soaring, just totally soaring after doing the Kickstarter, and it was greenlit and all that. I will say that after that, I was kind of thinking, oh, it would be so great to be able to get some consistent income now to be able to keep making this game, you know, like with alpha funding. So, but the alpha funding did not happen until I finally got the game to the point where it was like ready for people to start pre-ordering more, you know. So it took a good 6 months after the Kickstarter until the alpha funding really started kicking in. What did you do for a job before the Kickstarter? I did some web work. So I was like doing web design and things like that on the side, only for a few hours a day to try and just barely support myself to be able to make this game full time. So I was making this game full time and doing some part-time web work. Better salary for the mods. Voice of Grog, good evening. What's up, man? Steam mods. All right, so frame three, this is, okay, so her legs stay the same. The right arm, is it the right arm back? No, the right arm comes forward now. Gosh, I wanted to do like four enemies today, and I did one of the hardest enemies I could to start off. So now I'm not going to be able to get four enemies done in today's stream. Story of my life, man. Why am I always doing the challenging stuff? Especially first. Story of my life. Okay, let's get this arm looking better first. By the way, I absolutely love that you have cloud saves. Good. I was surprised to find save on my laptop and I made it on my PC. Yeah, sweet. I'm glad it worked too, Arcane. It's been working for me too. So I play the game on like three platforms. You know, I've got it on Windows, Mac, and Linux. And I kind of have to like, you know, spend some time testing it on Windows, some time testing it on Mac, and sometimes testing it on Linux just to make sure it's all good on each one of those. So yeah, when the Steam cloud save finally started working, I'm like, hell yes, it saved my save game. And it works cross-platform too. And it's really cool because you can just, if there's ever a conflict, it allows you the choice to either use the cloud version or use your local version. So it's actually really, really well written. I'm really, really stoked that it's that well written. Good job, Steam. Can you still support yourself as a web developer with all the damn $10 templates and frameworks dominating the market? Yeah, you can. You can. There's so many people out there that just don't know how to code at all. You know, and they need somebody to do something for them, you know. It doesn't matter if they already have a template that's $10. Some people will buy like a $10 template and then they still need someone to help them install it. So it is possible to make some dough to support yourself making games doing it that way. I barely scraped by though when I was doing it, because that's only because I only was putting in a few hours a day. You know, maybe sometimes even like 1 hour a day I would do web work, and then 8 hours a day I would be making Songbringer. That was only the first 4 months though of making the game, because That was my whole idea for the Kickstarter was basically this. I need to prove that this game is worth my time. I need to prove that this game is going to make money. So the whole plan was I'm going to spend a few months making a prototype. I'm going to launch a Kickstarter, and I'm going to use the results of the Kickstarter, whether they're positive or negative, as an indicator of where I should go next. So if my plan was if the Songbringer Kickstarter fails, that's great. I'll go get a job here in the Bay Area, and I'll just continue my life or whatever. And if it succeeds, then that's freaking awesome, and I'll be able to make my dream game. So it worked out, man. The Kickstarter succeeded, and I really recommend it to anyone else. Do a Kickstarter. Prove that your game is going to make money before you spend years making it. If that's your goal, if you want to make money making your game, you need to confirm that people are willing to pay for it before you spend years making it. Oh, cool. We got a little titty jiggle going on. Yeah. Jiggle. I was wondering, can you see how individual keys play the game? No, you can't. Like, can you see how much somebody played the game? Some statistics? No, they don't do it that way. I might be able to put in my own kind of analytics somehow. I might actually eventually do that, especially for crash reporting. I would love. It would be so cool if Steam had crash reporting. Why do they not have crash reporting? But yeah, crash reporting is probably the most important thing at first, and then secondly would be some basic statistics, analytics, like not particularly like this person played the game this much, but these, you know, the overall the game got played this much, this much, this much. You know, I don't want to take people's private information and identify people. I just want to be able to see, like, okay, this person played the game for five, or a person in general played the game for 5 minutes and quit or whatever. Or this person tried to launch it and it crashed. Or this person played for 30 minutes, or this person played for a whole 4 hours, or whatever. Yeah, there will be leaderboard. That's actually built into Steam. So Steam has their own API for leaderboards, and that will be soon. I'm actually going to do that pretty soon. Maybe even this week I'll do Steam leaderboards. So the next update, like this Saturday or maybe next Wednesday or whenever I do the next update, it'll have leaderboards. We'll see. Okay, I'm trying to see what this... Okay, this is frame 4, 3. I forget. Damn. I got to get this other one open again. Drobth walk. So there was this frame. And then he's... Oh, yeah, I forgot about the horns moving a little bit. That really helps. Okay, so it's the next frame where he's fully in this move and bouncing again. All right. So this frame, let's do a little bit of horn movement. Horn movement. That's a funny thing to say. Yep, definitely one of the more difficult animations I could have started today. Can't really get four of these done in one stream, but maybe I can get some other simple enemies done today. All right, so frame 3, jumping up in the air. How applicable are the principles of animation to pixel art? I'm not exactly sure. I'm not like a trained artist or anything. I'm totally just an amateur artist, really. So I couldn't say what are the... I don't even know what the principles of animation are. But I would think they're they're the same principles. Really, the only thing that's different is that pixel art is just such a lower resolution that you things get lost in the pixels, and your brain kind of fills in the gaps more with your imagination. Your imagination has to be used with pixel art. So there's that. So bouncing, this arm comes forward, that arm goes back. That somehow seems a little short. Like that. Okay, how much have you grown as an artist doing this project? Oh man, Lakebird, so much. I feel like I have so much. Yeah, let me show you something really quick. You'll be like, what? I've been chatting on the Cocos2DX forum lately. And, no, what? That's not it. Discuss Cocos2DX. Yeah, and I came across the old, very first screenshots that I posted on here. And they're laughable, man. They're laughable to me at this point, but... Look at this. I put this up here on Cocos2DX forum in February of 2015. So this is about a year ago. And this is what the art used to look like for Songbringer. And this is 2 months into making the game. So, I mean, this was kind of more than what used to be. And it used to be just like more like a brown screen. So this is like... The art is really, to me, it feels like the art has come a long ways. You know, everything was just more, just really it does not look that good. Looking back at these screenshots, I'm like, man, those are really ugly. Everything looks ugly to me. The font looks ugly. The lighting looks ugly. The rock texture looks just too gray. You know, so I feel like the art has really, really come a long way since then. Like, here's about halfway through the art phase, and then you get into more of, like, today's art. This is more what it looks like now. You know, you guys have seen. Better than my art? Well, you know what? But if you would have looked at my art, that's what I'm trying to say is, like, You grow as an artist, you know? We all grow doing whatever the heck we do, but like, you can grow as an artist too, it's all I'm trying to say. Not as good as my pixel leg. That's right, dude. Your pixel leg's awesome. You added some particles in your little game? Nice. Open link. Why is the link not opening? Come on, link. Okay, I'm just going to leave it open. Hopefully it opens here in a second. My internet's been crazy today. So I think this is a frame where our legs and stuff should really be stretching out. It's not opening. Come on, open Zyanger's link. Zyanger, can you maybe post it? Can you post a direct link to the image? This looks like the imager's imager's link? Like, is there, can you give me the actual ping or the actual GIF or whatever? Jizlo, I was developing something on Fusion 2.5, but that art was taking too long. Does working with pixel art speed things up? It depends. It really depends on what kind of pixel art style you're using. There's some pixel artists that are really detailed, and it can take longer to create your pixel art than it would creating normal art. But if you're like talking about my, like, the style that I'm using, this is a pretty quick pixel art style. Like, you can see when I want to change something, I'll just grab it and, you know, rotate things and blah blah blah, and go as quick as I can to make things happen and animate fast. I don't know. I guess it depends on you and your style and what you want to go for and stuff. I think she's done. This is now frame 2.2. Hold on. This last frame. Oh, wait. I need to make her head rotate a little bit, too. That'll help. This goes back to frame 3. Yeah. Okay. Ah, there we go. Oh, sorry, Zanger, it's not working. It's not opening for me. Ah. Let me just open it in this chat thing. Twitch, Wizard Foo. Chat. Oh yeah, I remember you showing this. Oh, cool particles. Nice. I love the bounce. I love the bounce. I love the way Zanger, I love the way you did is their animations too. Their walking animations are so cool. Awesome, man. All right, let's see how this looks. What's the skip? Why is she skipping like that? Hey! Hardboiled Egg wanted her to skip, and she's totally skipping on accident. You got your wish, man. But there's one more thing. I want this frame here. Her eye's gonna face a little more forward. What did I do? Come on. Move that eye. Move it. There we go. Maybe her titties should bounce in the air a little bit too. Not that pixel and that pixel. Boing. Let's see how that looks. That might be too much. Called it. Oh yeah, we definitely got some titty physics going on in this animation here. Titty physics. Is it, wait, what? Why? Oh, that's why it's got the skip going on. This, wait. Oh, okay. This frame up a pixel. All right, I don't know. Let's see it in the game. Before I make any more judgment calls or whatever. Some bounce physics. Drop female walk, render. Okay, let's see what this looks like. We need a room with a bunch of drops in it. Let's find a room. Let's find some kind of room that's gonna have drops in it. Maybe 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, I'm keeping the skip for now. That might be very apropos. Here we go. They're all female. Why are they all female? They look pretty good, actually. Okay, but it would be nice if they were both female and male. And it's my CPU is going crazy. Amazonian cult? Are they stronger than the males? No, they're not going to be stronger than the males, but I'm thinking they'll have some kind of interaction between them. So if there's females and males, maybe they're both a little more powerful. Like they complement each other somehow with their sexuality. So skin. All right. So I've got two skins. Okay. So there is going to be a little programming today because I want to see both the males and the females in the room at the same time. So skins, let's figure that out. There needs to be a baby drop. Should make a unique attack pattern requires both types to be near each other. Ah, right? Like something like that, yeah. That would be a kind of complex way to do it. But that would be cool. There's also the idea where, like, they just might be a little bit more powerful. Like, maybe they're just a little stronger if they're together, or smarter. Maybe the males are smarter if there's a female around or something like that. Making the baby attack. Oh, here's the skins. Okay, so it grabs the skins. It looks for a possible skin. No way. Did it actually randomly choose all females? Oh, no, no, no. It's just because I didn't list the other. Oh. Okay, this is simple. Basically, we need a regular skin. How do I do that? Blob. Black, black. Okay, yeah, so it just needs two tabs, two spaces. I need an empty skin. Smarter? Yeah, like smarter. Every enemy has intelligence. Oh, that did not work. Oh, they're there. They're totally enemies right here. They're not even moving. What are you guys doing? Why did that not work? Maybe, hold on, maybe that needs to be like that. Or males berserk when a female's around, right? Yeah. Hey, what's up, Spymore? Okay, that time we got all females again. If a male is close enough to a female, you can have like a dark glow around him and be stronger. Right, something simple like that, yeah. Okay, come on. We gotta figure this out. What's a YA? Should be. I'll just list out, I guess, what skins are being used. you can't get it to work, print it out, man. Printf. If the male is close to a female, he thumps his chest and charges at you. Yeah. Yeah, female enemies. That's what I'm making. So the reason I'm making male and female enemies in a lot of these, basically every level is going to have a male and a female version, is that these are actually supposed to be a group of people. So these are humans. In this game's universe, humans have been around our galaxy for millions of years, and they seeded many planets and then grew into different types of beings. So these are sort of like the more goat people or whatever. So that's why there's male and female for each one of these races. There's like an ant race, there's the goat race, there's a snake race. Where are the ant people? The ant people are not done yet, but I will have them. I'll be working on them maybe this week. So look at this. It shows skin female every time. Why is that? Possible. If val.size less than or equal to 0. All right, let me just step into this and figure out why it's parsing it wrong. Yes, thank you, Asinris. Debug, step this, figure this out. Okay, so we're making a vector of possible skins. We start with the value on this current val tree entry, which is I has the key dash female, the val is that. Okay, so val size, no, it's not going to be true. Key is going to be I.get key. Range equals this. Range should be 0 to 1. Give them an extra chromosome. Did you make a chance for male to spawn as a female? That's what I'm making right now. Yeah, I want them both to be in here. So yeah, 0 to 1. Okay, so yes. Oh, and what's the difficulty factor? 0.1. Okay. All right, so the next time it goes in, this is the... Oh! It exits out of the loop that fast? No wonder. Okay, what's skins? Skins, children, 1. Oh, it didn't parse correctly. Why not? Why didn't it parse correctly? Messing with me, huh? Messing with me. Maybe I just need to do that. Yeah, I will. I'll eventually do that. That's kind of the last thing I can get to, right? The more important thing now is finishing enemies, finishing the dungeons, adding in all the items, finishing the story, and then mods will be like the icing on top of the cake. It's going to be a while before mods are a real reality. Okay, so skins, this is the most important part. Yes, we have two children this time. One child, two child, first child. It's a two-letter word. Val, okay, val, what's that? Val is empty key. Yeah, so if it's empty, then the val is going to be the actual key. So val is 0 to 1. Key is empty. Yeah, this worked that time. Range 0 to 1. Good. So that'll push that back. So that's all I needed to do. I needed to just make it. I don't know why it didn't work with the two tabs and the two spaces. Probably stop. I don't know. It's kind of worrisome, though. There's probably a bug in Valtry. These children grow up so fast. All right, so this one has the key, dash female. All right, I think it worked that time. Show skin blank. Show skin blank. All right. Now they're all male again. Oh my god. Ugh. What the hell? Random. What's the random number? Maybe it's not even seeding it with a random number here. Random. Nope, 0.28. Okay, so possible is it's got two different entries. One of them's the right one, the male, and then there's, okay. Possible is correct. It must just not be choosing a random number. Or maybe they all are randomly male. Okay, so this one random number is 0.28 once again. 0.28. That's the same random number every time. Why is that? Oh, it's passing in that. That's so wrong. I believe this has an int I. Spymort, choose skin blank. No, that's actually right, Spymort. Yeah. Show skin blank. This, the blank skin is the male skin, the regular, the first, you know, skin or whatever. The dash female is the second skin. So there's blank and dash female. So I, yeah, this one's I3. Okay, here's a simple way to do this. It's gonna do a random number. Based on what is this area creation? Create being, create AI. So this is going to be I mod width, and this is going to be I divided by width. So that way we're taking in the, actually this could be 1 plus. Yeah, so that should return a different random number for each one of them. So this should work.
Probably dark in here, huh?
Sorry about that. Ah. Yeah, all right. It worked. Got some males and some females. I'd like it for the females to be a different hue, though. It's pretty cool, though, seeing some slightly different different drops in there. Okay. Hey, what's up, Steve Tramby? Yo, man. It's working. All right. So, and she also needs that her own dying animation. Okay, let's start with just the idle animation. I want to play with a different hue. Got to turn off flux because flux is already on. Okay. I'm thinking just her body color is a little bit different. So I'll apply some hue. Yeah, I'm thinking that, like some negative hue. This makes her a little more purple, a little less red. Okay, I'll try that. And I'll try it on the walk animation too. Man, learning all the different class names for Bootstrap is almost as much work as just writing the styles yourself. Oh my god, yeah. Bootstrap. I know, like, Bootstrap is I guess the concept's pretty neat, but, like, it felt too kind of bloated to me, you know? It's like, it was just too much. Like, I wanted a more simple framework. Personally. But I am kind of more of a minimal type of person in everything. Okay, so there, that's hue. 1, 2, 3. Right, yeah, do one thing, do it well principle. I love that principle. When I found out that Unix's entire philosophy was that, do one thing and do it well, that's when I was like, oh my god, I love Unix. I love Linux. Okay, we finally have all these ready. You should definitely use a collection of pre-made styles, reset, font capabilities, vector UI. Yeah, bootstraps off an overkill, right? All right, let's see how this looks. Turn off this gray background. Okay, so not all of our animations are finished, but we'll at least be able to see in general what she looks like with more of a purple hue now. And what the benefit of doing having all those hue layers in there is that I can easily go and make a different hue. Like if I wanted to make a purple drop female or whatever, done. Or a yellow one. They're all hiding in the dark. I want to see you, don't hide in the dark. Right, okay, so the guys kind of have more of a rusty red color, and the girls have more of a purpley red color. I like this, and I like that hue. This is awesome. We have female characters. And an alternate form of this sort of like a grunt soldier. That's really what the drops are. Okay, so I'm going to finish her up by, okay, her colors look good. This walk animation looks good. There's one animation left to do, and that's her die animation. But I don't need this anymore. The idle animation did have one problem. It needed a second frame. How you been, Steve Tramby? How's things going, man? All right, this one's ready to render. Right, hopefully it increases dramatically once you learn everything, right? Okay, next up, hurt. This is the easiest animation ever. One single frame. I love single frame animations. It's not even technically an animation yet, if it's only a single frame. Is that right? This ain't no animation. But I like it. Let's get rid of that pixel there. And maybe add one there. Yeah, that looked good. Okay. So she's hurt. She's weaker. Render this one frame. Female hurt 0. Okay, her dying and her attack. Attack. First frame. Second frame. What I don't get is usually animators target a specific frame rate for their animations, right? So when my PC is spitting out 100 frames a second, are those 60 frames just divided out evenly over the 100? Yeah. Basically, if you have a lot of my animations are 10 frames per second, which means that for 6 of the actual frames, it's displaying the same animation frame. You feel guilty when you create a one-frame animation? That's right. Yes, one system, right? All right, almost done with this one. And then there's one more animation to draw, her dying animation, and she's good to go. Just make sure all that came through okay. Before I do that last animation. Did I use up the whole stream just doing this one character? I think I probably did. Yeah, I like her. I like her. She's got a little bit more saturated of a color too. And there's actually no more saturation applied, but she looks more saturated. She's kind of like a strong female, that's for sure. Right, yeah. There are some games that are programmed that way. And so they do handle their animations different. Okay, last animation. Okay, so she's gonna die. I want her to die differently than the other drop. The other drop like falls over like this. Maybe she'll fall backwards. You got it. All right, cool, man. You got an interview in 8 hours? Wow. Good job, Legbird. A student programmer position? Cool. Good luck, man. I hope you get it. I hope everything goes well. What's really nice about dying animations is that you can let the pixels get really dirty and it doesn't matter. I'm thinking she falls over. Maybe the first frame she leans back a bit and her arms cover up her core. Your egghead progress? You making changes to this? Ooh, hey! Oh my god, hardboiled, really? Dude, I gotta give you props for this, man. Okay, you guys, hardboiled just started making pixel art. Like, he tweeted me yesterday about it. He's like, hey, what software should I use? This was yesterday. And already, you're starting to master color depth and hue depth very well. The way you're using the blues in the shading is very good, man. And you already got a nice long-haired look going, too, which you wanted to accomplish. So good job, man. This is excellent pixel art right here. Excellent. Yeah, great shading, man. Great shading. Well, I got my fingers crossed for you, Lakebird. Oh, the shading, it's almost all A sprite? Really? Born to Snipe and the Grim Gary. What's up, you guys? Welcome, welcome, welcome. I'm working on the last frames of animation for this new female Drobth character. Each one of the levels in Songbringer is going to have, the dungeons are all going to have this different races of people. There's a race of people called the goat people or whatever, the Drobth people, whatever these are. They're goat humans, basically. There's the ants race, there's the snake race, and there's two other races, which I'll introduce over the next coming months. So I'm working on the female. So each one of the races of people has a female and a male character. Yeah, good luck. Get some sleep, man, for sure. Good evening, Nat. Nice, Jacob. Now she's armed. She is armed. She has arms. Okay, so next frame, I want her to lean back a little bit farther. This is her death animation. She's in the throes. And like I was saying earlier, it's so nice to make death animations because you can let your pixels get all junky and it really doesn't matter. A sprite looks pretty cool, yeah. Do I plan on putting any Easter eggs in the game? Heck yeah! As many as I freaking can. I love Easter eggs. It's on sale right now, really? I didn't know it was on Steam. $10.94, $10.49. Brr. Whoa, cool. All right. This one, he's a little farther back. Multiple step Easter eggs? Sure, why not? I love Easter eggs, and they're really fun to make too. Oh, right. A year of Photoshop for Christmas. Yeah, I like Photoshop too, but yeah, not as myopic. That's a good way to describe it. Yeah, Photoshop is, I don't know, it's a lot more powerful, but it's also, I don't know, sometimes it's a bit too complicated for pixel art. It really, once again, it all depends on how, you know, what kind of things you're doing with it and how you're, what kind of art you're making with it or whatever. Junky, junky pixels, yeah. All right, last frame. Legs fall down. She's toast. What programming language should I learn first, then go into game development with it? Well, man, that really depends on what kind of games you want to make, what platforms you want to release them on. Every time I switch from Java to C Sharp is how they do their namespace to wrap classes. At this point in this era, Jacob, any language will do. Yeah, it's a good way to put it. What you need to look at is what you want to develop for a platform. Yeah, like I was just about, that's why I was asking you, what platform you want to make it for, and or what basically what platforms do you want to release your games on? What kind of game do you want to make too? That also has something to say about what kind of game, what kind of language you're going to use. For example, if you want to make a game that's sort of like web playable or whatever. You're probably not going to want to use certain language. You're probably going to want to use like JavaScript or any kind of thing that can interface well, WebGL or whatever. All right, see you, Zanger. But if you just want to learn a language and it really doesn't matter that much at this point, I would recommend C. think that's probably one of the most important languages anyone should ever learn. It's kind of the root of many other languages, and it will teach you memory and pointers and all the other important things that you need to know in a lot of other languages. Some languages you don't need to know that anymore, but still you're going to learn the foundation of memory, you know, which is, it's our heritage, man. You got to know our heritage. A game like ours, but I know I won't be that good at first. Maybe Pong. Oh, yours? Okay, so you want to make like a game that's like playable on Windows, Mac, and Linux. My project for this weekend is figuring out how to make a mail server automatically dump email attachments into a specific folder on the server. Huh. Depends on what kind of mail server you're using. If you're using like postfix or whatever, it's pretty easy. Yeah, true. Grim Gary. What Grim Gary just said right there, also very insightful, very important. Key thing is once you understand basic programming logic, you can pick up other languages pretty quickly. Yes. So there you go. That's why learning something like C is a good thing. Once you've learned the basic principles of how languages work, you're good to go. It's really easy to learn other languages. This works. I guess this works. Let's see this in the game. Turn on this gray background. She's not gonna be the right hue first, but it's okay. Female die. Replace. Let's do a git status to make sure all these files came out all right too. I think it is. That's die. Oh, there's 14 frames of die now. That can't be right. Let's try that again. Female die. Yeah, now we got die 0 through 6. All these other ones look good. Okay, so see how that looks. Pi game. Yeah, Python's a good one too. Definitely. Khan Academy, great thing to try. Khan Academy, yeah, good for a lot of subjects, but programming as well. MIT, really? That worked. I like this animation for her dying. Okay. So, last thing I need to do is make her hue correct. Yeah. All right, so I'm about done with the stream here. Just about. I'm still going to finish up this dying animation and then put it in the game and run it one last time. But hey, at least one more skin of an enemy is done. I was going to start a new brand new enemy today, but I thought I would be able to get this done quicker. But tomorrow I'll start some new enemies or maybe a new boss or something. All right, so making the hue, applying this to all of her frames. This is great to have all these hue layers in here because, first of all, you know, she looks a little different for her current animations. But second of all, I can easily go in later and make, like, a whole different skin really quickly. Books, lots of books. Yeah, books are great. I learned from a book to program C. But this was 20 years ago before we had all these awesome online tutorials. Yay, last frame. Whoops. All right, render. Still got the right frames, yep. Cool. You have the advantage of comp sci professors to glom onto back in the 90s. Mm-hmm. There weren't all these fancy webs, right? You kids and all your awesome resources these days, seriously. Let it be known. You guys have it good. You guys have game engines? We didn't have game engines in the 90s. Back in MS-DOS? There were a couple game engines, but they were expensive. We're talking thousands of dollars, some of these things, to license, to even use. Source code, everything was not as open source as it is today. The one thing about her is I think maybe her titties should bounce a little bit different when she's walking. I need to focus on that. There's a couple frames in there where they're bouncing a little too much. Yeah, I'll definitely focus on that because that's could look better. But other than that, I think this is looking pretty good. Her hue's a little different. It's really nice seeing this variety of different drops on here. These are your books, huh? Sweet. Postgres, C++. Right on. Allegro, that's right, Allegro! That one was free, right? Comic book and illustration guides. Nice. Okay, so that's it for today's stream. I'll be back tomorrow. Yeah. Go to sleep. I might even sleep myself. I don't know. But yeah, you guys, thanks again for all your support and everything. The beta release went really well. Got a lot of great comments. A lot of people have already done Let's Plays on the game, and I'm really excited to keep developing this game, keep making it awesome, get it out. So yeah, have a good night, you guys. Cheers.